Apple just announced a huge update to how we can price our apps on the App Store. They've introduced 700 new price increments from as low as 29 cents all the way up to, wait for it, $10,000. $10,000. But if you want to price your app or subscription above $1,000, you have to get specific permission from Apple to do so, which should prevent stuff like this, if you remember the I Am Rich app. Of course, that was $999, so that would still be under the $1,000, so you still could do that, but it couldn't get as excessive as the $10,000 one. But more flexibility on how we can price our app is always a welcome thing, and here's a chart from Apple explaining how the increments work. As you can see, we get 10-cent increments all the way up to $10, and then it goes to 50-cent increments from $10 to $50, and so forth. As you can see, that is how we get these 700 new price points. Another new thing is a new convention. Right, everything used to end in 99 cents, you know, 1.99, 2.99. Now we can have it end in these conventions, which include nice round numbers. Like, I know there's pricing psychology around why everything is like 99 cents, but I like the nice round numbers of like $10 instead of 9.99, so I think I'm gonna go with that in my app. Another update is developers will be able to choose a local storefront that acts as a basis for the pricing on all the other storefronts and currencies all around the world. And if you like, you're still able to set individual prices per storefront. Now, when are these new price increments and local territory pricing available to you? Well, if you have an app that has auto-renewable subscriptions, it's available right now, today, or actually December 6th was the official day of the announcement. For actual one-time purchases of your app or consumables, you know, in-app purchases, that will roll out in spring of 2023.